Hello everyone, I'm Captain NakedPanda and this will be my very first YouTube posted theory. What we will be talking today is the end of Whole Cake Island, which I believe has already been shown to us. But first, let me gear up. For my very first video, I wanted to bring you one of my old theories which I created back in May. And lately, I see more clues proving that might actually be right. Without boring into depth with my introduction, I hope you can find time to enjoy this video because I haven't seen anybody looking at the things the way I do. As you can guess from the title, I'm gonna talk about the end of Whole Cake Island and how, in my opinion, Oda already gave us big clues about it. However, I'm not gonna predict who's gonna defeat who. What I'll be talking about is one of the final scenes in the arc. But first, bear with me while I will lead you to the final moment. What I want to start with is back in chapter 828, and more specifically, the introduction scene for Pudding. When Pudding covered for Luffy and Chopper, all the prison straw hats and Pudding talked about Sanji and how great he is, and Pudding's description on Sanji was spot on. He was kind and gentleman, his eyes being shaped like hearts, Pudding specifically stating that he knows a lot about making sweets, he taught her also few things, and Pudding stating, quote unquote, "I'm sure he would protect me." But there is a big but in here, because the description of Sanji raises several questions in here. Because up to this point of the story, Sanji and Pudding have never met. So when did Sanji and Pudding meet? When did they have time to share all these stories and hobbies? When did Sanji teach Pudding actually to cook? Let's keep these questions in our mind and focus on the next key moment that I want to point out. This moment is forward in the story where Pudding and Big Mom were talking about her third eye and the hint that it should possess special powers connected to the voice of all things. However, from what I have found and what we have seen in the previous arcs, I don't think that this is the only power the third eye might have. If you remember, not long ago, the One Piece community had an idea on Pudding's devil fruit. And what if people were speculating that she might have some kind of time manipulation devil fruit because of all the clocks present around Pudding in all the panels that Oda drew? Then after her Memo Nomi was revealed, everybody dropped the idea completely. But I don't think that we were completely wrong, we just misread the situation a little. In my opinion, the clocks were actually a hint toward her third eye power. In many cultures, there are stories about third eye being the symbol of a true vision, which is most often connected with power to see the future. And as we know, time, and in this case the clocks, represents both the past and the future. If you think about it, her devil fruit let her see the past of a person, and maybe her third eye can let her see the future. If that's true, then the speculation about Pudding having powers related to time were not completely wrong, right? And yeah, I know guys, up to now we're just blabbing and just speculating about stuff with no proof. So let me present you now with what I believe to be very solid argument supporting my theory. If we go back to the first key moment where I have pointed out how Pudding is describing Sanji very precisely, we can actually see from the latest development in the manga that almost everything that she said came true, or is about to come true. First one is that Sanji was very kind to her in being gentleman. Both of the situations were verified when Pudding and met Sanji for first time, and during the wedding when he brought her to tears with a single compliment even though he knew that she was lying. Second one is when Pudding stated that Sanji is strong and he would protect her, and he already did that during the wedding, and most probably he is gonna do it again during the baking of the cake. But what is the most interesting part is that the Pudding specifically pointed out that he is good with making sweets, and that he even taught her something. This is happening exactly in the latest chapters where they are baking the cake for Big Mom. Plus, the way that Sanji is bossing around everybody, he's probably about to show them how they can do things better and faster. Also, not to mention that Sanji said that he has a surprise for Big Mom in relation to the cake. So this situation played out exactly according to Pudding's description. But probably now you're questioning, how is Pudding using these powers to see the future, or is she hiding her powers from her family? So what I want to clarify here is that it seems that Pudding has no idea that she's using her powers. What I can conclude from the information until now, Pudding is most likely using her powers during her sleep, dreaming about these events. I have reached this conclusion because of certain phrasing that Pudding used. Back in chapter 828, Pudding is indirectly explaining to the Straw Hats her relationship with Loa, and knowing Loa's character, we can imagine for sure that they were having some kind of girl talks and how should their Prince Charming look and so on. But what struck me the most is that in the next moment Pudding is stating clearly, quote unquote, "And along came Sanji. He was so wonderful. I thought he came out of one of my dreams." This really proves the point that she was dreaming about the moment when her Prince Charming is in front of her. Up until now in the series, we had people reading or seeing the future. Madame Charlotte with her crystal ball, Hawkins with his cards, Katakuri mastering even Haki. So what are we missing? We're missing a dreamer. Person that reads the future while I was asleep and dreaming. So in my opinion, Pudding is a dreamer able to tell the future, but she doesn't know it yet. Hopefully, I managed to convince you until now that there is such possibility, and it's time to bring in the most exciting thing about this theory. Seeing that all moments described by Pudding are coming true, I searched further to see what else did Pudding state it, and I have found something very, 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 very interesting. During the first encounter with Pudding, she shared with Straw Hats that Sanji taught her something in their first meeting, which I already mentioned that they didn't have up to that moment in the story. Pudding stated, quote unquote, "The truth is, in the end, he shared something with me. I really want to marry you, but I can't. I've got to return to my friends." And they're standing in a beautiful field with flowers and rainbows, which really resembles the style in Whole Cake Island. It's perfect end moment to resolve the relationship between Sanji and Pudding. And could this be a panel telling the future? I think it is, guys. But that's not all. If that certainly is a flash forward panel, do you notice that around Sanji and Pudding there are a lot of hills, clouds, rainbows, structures, flowers, but none of them is a homie? Could that mean that Big Mom has died or lost her powers for some reason? Or homies are just not drawn in this case? And I know some people will say that Luffy already said that Big Mom is gonna be next after Kaido, and there is no way that Big Mom will die or lose her powers in this specific arc. But everything about this arc is about controversy. In one moment we receive confirmation about something, and few chapters later, everything turns 180 degrees. Could the unresolved issue about Mother Caramel, Big Mom, and her memories play some role for Big Mom losing her powers? Since she didn't acquire them but a typical way of eating a devil fruit, but eating a devil fruit user. And specifically the so-so fruit. I'll let you think about that. Below the video, I'm gonna post the link to the original theory in Oro Jackson. So if you feel like it, go and check it out as well. So tell me, what do you think about in the comment section below? Like the video if you've enjoyed it, dislike if you didn't, and please subscribe if you want to be notified for my future content. I'm wishing you an amazing day. The captain is signing Naked and out.